I was almost by the, at the finish, and this year I will finish the race, you know, and I will win it, you know. I'm very focused about it, but.
바다의 빛과 그림자, 그것은 젊음이 나온 폭주인가? 과하다 싶을 정도로 넘쳐흐르는 타고난 투쟁 본능인가? 3월 레이세포, 6월 그라우베 페이토자, 9월 최홍만, 12월 피터 아츠, K1의 정상급 파이터들을 연달아 파괴하며 그 여세를 몰아 월드 그랑프리를 제패한 것도 시간 문제인 것으로 여겨졌다. 그러나 시대 총화는 많은 기대를 저버리고 K1 그 자체마저 파괴해 버렸다.
Well, I'm a bad boy, so I just apologize for the fans, but that's it.
사상 최초로 결승전에서의 반칙패를 기록하더니 뚜렷한 출전 동기도 없이 나섰던 12월 31일 경기에선 MMA 파이터 알리스타 오브레임에게 굴욕적인 KO패를 당했다. 챔피언의 자리를 넘보던 남자가 펼쳐 보인 허망한 모습, 전대미문의 빛과 그림자.
You know that was then, and you know this is now. So I don't think about it. You know, I just black page in my book. You know, and I was very close, but not close enough. You know, because I ruined it for myself.
Speed, power, stamina. 모든 점에 있어 현재 정상의 위치에 있는 것은 틀림없다. 6월엔 난공불락의 3연패 챔피언 세미 슐트와 맞섰고. 충격적인 KO승 거두며 부활. 언제 챔피언이 돼도 이상하지 않을 바다하리. 그러나 그에게는 한 가지 암흑이 존재한다. 그것은 바로 그 특유의 승부욕이며 어쩌면 유일한 약점일 수도 있는 그 전투 본능이다.
낙아웃 is when you punch somebody and he just sleeps for 5 minutes, you know. That's a knockout, you know. So that's what we want to see, you know.
분노 그리고 증오. 이번에 그가 그 감정을 폭발시킬 상대는 K1 월드 그랑프리 2009 유럽 챔피언 자빗 사메도프. K1에 참가한 지 3년 만에 드디어 손에 넣은 파이널 16의 자리. 헤비급 중에선 결코 크지 않은 자격이지만 바다 아리 못지않은 치열한 전투 본능의 소유자다. 헤비급 파이터답지 않은 스피드와 테크닉을 무기로 대망의 첫 출전. 그 초전부터 우승 후보에 도전한다. 2009년 바다하리에게 빛이 비추게 될 것인가? 아니면 또다시 암흑에 갇히게 될 것인가?
I have no limits. The world has never seen power as mine. There is no answer to it. The world is mine. Whose?
그 충격으로 서울이 흔들리게 될 오늘의 메인 이벤트, 바다하리 대 자빗 사메도프.
Samadov, the K1 European Champion 2009, has remained undefeated this year, winning all four fights, including those three in one night in Lodz, Poland, to take the European Grand Prix title and qualify for the final 16 for the first time ever. Representing both Belarus and Azerbaijan, he was born in Georgia, where his Azeri parents moved to East Belarus when he was just 10 years old. K1 record of 12-3-2 knockouts, overall career record 69-9 with 30 knockouts. One of the smaller heavyweights in K1, only 6 foot and 207 pounds or 94 kilos of Zabit Samadov. Had a busy year in 2008 as well, with 9 fights going 7-2, including wins over Rusevo in Taiwan after 2 extension rounds, and beat Doug Viney and Peter Erskine Brian Lewis to reach the final of the 2008 K1 European Grand Prix in Amsterdam, where he lost to Errol Zimmerman. Finished 2008, of course, with a lackluster performance against Tyrone Spong in Eindhoven. He's a real tournament specialist, is Samadov, having won 4 8-man tournaments.
But yeah, excitement also.
I can smell the bad boy. It's not a hurry about to make you famous.
K1 월드 그랑프리 2009 인 서울 파이널 60. 오늘의 마지막 경기를 시작하도록 하겠습니다. 먼저 블루 코너, 신장 183cm, 체중 89kg, 진욱짐 소송 2009년 K1 유럽 챔피언 자빗 사메더프.
Zabit Samadov, 12-3, only 2 knockouts in his
이어서는 레드 코너, 신장 190cm, 체중 100.2kg, 쇼타임 소소, 배드보이, 바다! 허리!
Wow, that is just crazy.
이 경기에 주시는 가쿠다 심판입니다.
Because everyone here is on the edge of their seats. But a hurry, an amazing 13-5 with 12 knockouts. A massive 92% KO ratio. Overall career record 71-9-1. 58 knockouts and 80% career KO ratio. We are ready 3x3. 2 extra rounds in case of a draw. 3 knockdowns in 1 round and it's all over. Bookmakers have Butter Hurry as the overwhelming favorite. He is minus 470. Zabit Samadov plus 390. Third man in centering, the legendary Nobuaki Gakuda, Michael Chiavello, Mike Kogan with your ringside. The final place.
Round one!
December 5 in Yokohama. Samadov gives away height, gives away reach, gives away experience and power. He's got a move. He's got a stick and move. He's got about to score, but a hurry.
Not down.
Try a head kick knockout, butter.
It's 6'6".
Butter is just deceptively tall. Butter. He goes, Mikey, I didn't realize how tall Butter actually is until I was in the ring with him. And with the chopping leg kicks early on from Butter Hurry.
Those leg kicks are going to end this round because that time when someone else fell, they didn't count it, but I think he slipped. I think that was from the kick.
Hurry's got a nice with a look for a knockout. This is knocking Fred's way of adrenaline racing like knocking an opponent. He spent a lot of time in Morocco recently. Gets to the king of Morocco. He's absolutely mobbed by fans in Morocco. He flies both the Moroccan and the Dutch flag. Jab! Leg kick! Cracking power from Hurry.
And you know what? It's to be said, when we spoke to him yesterday, the day before yesterday, he seems like not necessarily a different kind of Hurry, but a more mature, a more calm, a more focused. He wants to get to the very top, and he wants that crown. He just seemed, I don't know, he just seemed maybe a little more mature. He said he went to Morocco for 3 months to kind of rebuild himself, his soul, his body. He's got a six-pack. Definitely rebuild his
body. Oh, God.
This is just devastating power display here in the first round from Butter Hurry. Everything is just wanting to kill.
If he makes it out of this round, we might see a little more of him. But so far, it's all
about Hurry. Hold on.
Semenov, that's the second high kick attempt he has done. You can already see the right side of the carcass is just reddened. Looks like it's been Korean barbecued here in Seoul.
Down! One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine.
That's good for Hurry! Fittingly, it's the only
knockout in the final 6 games. 2분 27초 만에 멋진 바다 하리 선수의 KO승입니다. 위너! 바다 하리! 멋진 KO승을 한 바다 하리 선수입니다. 필스 커플레이션 시니어 매니징 디렉터 키어하루 아키아와로부터 클로피 선단이 이겼습니다.
And he's just done it with one single body shot to the bread basket of Sabit Semenov.
경기 승리한 바다리 선수에게 필스 코퍼레이션 시니어 매니징 디렉터 미스터 키오하루 아키야마 상으로부터 트로피 전달이 있습니다.
Several regional tournaments, runner-up also in the K1 Grand Prix European last year. Sabit Semenov is no slouch, Mike Hogan.
Oh, no.
And I've never
자,
seen
여러분이 원하신다면 모든 선수를 링으로 불러오도록 하겠습니다. 여러분 박수 부탁드립니다. 그럼 네덜란드 메비 말호프 그럼 네덜란드 Rami Bonjasky. From Brazil, Clove Peitoza. From Chilas, Iceland, Aaron Silverman. From Japan, Kyotaro. From Russia, Ruslan Karaev. From India, Sikhat Javibu. From Brazil, Everton Teixeira. From Romania, Daniel Kita. From Netherlands, Sammy Schuur.
at the Yokohama Ring, I tell you, it is
from Japan, Musashi.
On paper, it is a hard one to
from
call.
Romania, Daniel Kita. From France, Jerome Benner. From Netherlands, Alistair Oberley. From Netherlands, once again, Peter Arch. From Belarus, Javis Shamedov. Finally, from Morocco, Tada Harry. Here's K1 World Grand Prix 2009. Final 16. 모든 경기를 마치도록 하겠습니다. 멋진 경기를 펼쳐주신 선수들에게 다시 한번 큰 박수 부탁드립니다. 피어스 K1 월드 그랑프리 2009 파이널은 12월 5일 토요일 일본 요코하마 아레나에서 개최됩니다. 올해 K1 킹 오브 킹스가 결정되는 결승전에도 많은 기대와 성원 부탁드립니다. This is the K1 World Grand Prix 2009 Seoul Final 6의 모든 대회를 마치고 마지막까지 관람해주신 여러분께 다시 한번 깊은 감사의 말씀을 드리겠습니다. 다가오는 12월에 요코하마 아레나에서 다시 만나도록 하겠습니다. 안녕히 돌아가십시오.
Well, there you go, folks. It is going to happen December 5 at the Yokohama Arena in Tokyo. Don't forget, before then, we have the K1 Max Grand Prix final. The final four will duke it out on October 26th at the Yokohama Arena as Max takes on its largest venue ever. Mikey Kogan, brother, it's been a pleasure, as always, to be here ringside with you. There are the eight men who will duke it out for the title come December 5 at the Yokohama Arena. What a hurry. Alistair Overy, Jerome Lebanon, Simi Schultz, Evident Teixeira, Ruslan Karayev, Errol Zimmerman, and Billy Bonfasky. The draw will be held tomorrow. You'll be able to check it out. It will be uploaded onto YouTube. Go through K1Edition.com. You'll also check out YouTube.com/K1. Some fantastic archival footage. Okay, Mike Kogan, Mota Hurry goes in as our favorite. Who goes in as the second favorite for me?
Remy is really good at achieving twice he really won. The third time, you know, I think Badahari kind of gave it to him and let him win. But most definitely is the favorite, of course, Remy Bojanski. But Badahari would have to be my first choice.
Okay, then I'm going to go Badahari first choice. Let's go Remy Bojanski second choice. Semi Shields are locking for third place.
I probably would put Semi Shields over Remy. Sure.
Okay, folks, there it is from the beautiful Seoul Olympic Gymnasium, K1 Final 16, Michael Shimano, Mikey Kogan.